are going to take reading. We are going to oscillate the disc. 1, 2, 3. Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stop. 6, 7, 8, 9. Stop. Yes. Okay. So this is our graph we have plotted from the experimental setup. So we have to find the natural frequency of the system with the help of logarithmic decrement. So logarithmic decrement is nothing but it is a natural log to the ratio of any two successive amplitudes on either side of this line. Start. Okay, as per we got frequency response over the paper, now we are going to discuss to calculate the theoretical values for natural frequency. So these are the formulas we required to calculate the natural frequency theoretically. First is polar moment of inertia for the disc, that is IP is equal to pi by 32 d raised to 4. Then torsional stiffness, that is K theoretical GIP divided by capital L. Then mass moment of inertia, I is equal to mr square by 2. Then natural frequency omega n is equal to under root k theoretical divided by I, and frequency theoretically omega n divided by 2 pi in hertz. So these are the calculations. First we have to calculate from the given technical specifications and observation, that is polar moment of inertia, then theoretical torsional stiffness, then mass moment of inertia with the help of formula, then natural frequency omega n and frequency theoretical in hertz with the help of omega n upon 2 pi. Then we have to calculate the natural frequency practically with the help of this formula. Practical natural frequency is equal to number of oscillations divided by time required for that oscillation. So we'll get, for 5 oscillations we get a time here 8.47 seconds, and for 10 oscillations we got 16.7 seconds time almost. When we see from this graph, for 10 oscillations the time required, then 5 oscillations is almost double, that is 8.47 we got 16.7 seconds for the amplitude response. Then last, this is a result table in which we have to compare theoretical natural frequency with practical natural frequency, and conclusion from this experiment that we have to study the type of vibratory system to determine the natural frequency of the given plate which is attached to the string in the experimental setup, and we have to find natural frequency and compare theoretical natural frequency with practical natural frequency. So we'll provide you this amplitude response or this experimental setup readings. I'll provide this photo to you on the group. You should have to take a Xerox of this photograph and put this Xerox in your journal, okay, experiment.